Hello students, today we will be discussing the chapter 5 of computer in class 9. The name of the chapter is more features of a word processor. So the first topic that we will be discussing is spelling and grammar. Sometimes we might want to check whether some spelling and grammar of a certain text that we have written is correct or not. For that, we select the text that we want to check. We go to review tab. Under the proofing tab, we will find spelling and grammar. So when we click there, so it tells us whether the spelling and grammar is correct or not. The steps for that you will find in the book, which I will not be discussing. Next topic is thesaurus. Now, thesaurus simply means synonyms. So the thesaurus tool provides a list of synonyms, that is words with similar meaning for a given word, and can be used to replace a word with one of its synonyms. So for example, we can select any word from here and we can look for the thesaurus of it. Next topic is changing case. So sometimes it happens that when we are writing and we did not pay attention whether our keyboard is caps lock is pressed or not, and when we have written, maybe we want something in completely capital letters, but we have written that in small letters. So there we can, there is an option in home tab where we can change a certain line, the text of a certain line, completely capital letter or lower letter, or some other options are also there. For example, so if we change it to lowercase, so all the words in that particular line have become small lettered. Similarly, you can completely change it to uppercase. Sentence case. Next, capitalize each word. Sorry, I haven't selected it yet. So we must select the line before applying this feature. And lastly, toggle case. Now toggle case simply change every letter, depending whether it is capital or not, to the alternate one. So a capital letter word, capital letter will become a small letter, and a small letter will become a capital letter, and vice versa. Next feature that we will discuss is find and replace. So finding a text, sometimes in a large document you might want to look for some text in the document. So looking for it manually is very cumbersome, so we have an option of finding the text. So we go to home tab. In the editing group, we will find the option called find. So when you click there, a certain navigation bar will come where we can look for the word that we want. Similarly, there is another option called replace. So when you press there, there will be a certain option for looking for a text, finding the text, and what we want to replace that text with. We can provide those two terms in those two boxes, and then, for example, let me select this word and press on replace. Now see, we are looking for word and we want to, maybe we want to replace it with word. So first of all, we press on find next. And if you want to replace, we'll just press on replace and it will replace the current occurrence of the word. And if you press on replace all, it will replace this particular word wherever in the document it finds the same word with the word WARD. So we have pressed replace and see now this word is changed. Next topic is bullets and numbering. So we have discussed bullets and numbering before also. So sometimes we want to make a list of something, maybe some words that we want to do, we want to keep them in a list. So for that we maintain a unordered list. So unordered lists are also known as bullets. See, there are different options that you want to select in the bullet library. So let me select this one, and now you can write anything that you want, and see, so all the different options appears there. The next option that is available here is called numbering. So sometimes we don't want to list them as unordered list, we want to make them ordered list. So to make them ordered list, we select one of these options. So they can be numerical number 1, 2, 3, or they could be Greek number 1, 2, 3. Or there are many options that are available there. Next topic is symbols. Symbols are the signs or special characters that can be inserted in a Word 2010 document. Symbols such as hearts, stars, and arrows can be inserted and formatted in a document just like regular text. Each font has a separate set of symbols. So to insert a symbol, we go to the Insert tab. There, you will find this symbol button under symbols group. When you press there, some commonly used symbols you will find there, but if you don't find that particular symbol there, you can click on more symbols and it will give you a list of all the symbols that are available with that current font. Remember, you might not find the symbol you are looking for in with your current font. So for that, you might have to download a different font, and with that font, you will be able to find the symbol you are looking for. Next topic is creating tables. Now, in MS Word, we can create tables in multiple ways. So first of all, we go to Insert, and under Tables group, we will find a table. So from there, we can select the size of the table. So there are many methods. First, we can use this particular grid. See, if you want to create a 4x3 table, then I'll click in this particular box and which will create this particular table of size 4x3. But we can change it also. So maximum the maximum size of the table that you can create with grid with 10x8, because no more boxes are available. So let's say we want to change, make the table even bigger than that. For that, we can click on this option, Insert Table, and from there, we can select the size that we want that will create the table for us. Some more options are also there. For example, Draw Table. It will draw a table for us, or quick table. Which will provide us with many different style of tables that you can select from. For now, let me select this table of size 5x3. Next topic is formatting a table. So once you have created a table, it looks very basic. It has only black colored borders and white background. But we can change all of that with the design tab. So after creating the table, you have to select the table and go to design tab. There you will find different options. If you click there, see, you will see different options. Let me make this table bigger. See, you can change the style of the table. Even more styles are available. You can select whatever style you are comfortable with. Next topic is changing the row height or column width. So each table cell has a certain row height and column width. You can change them using the steps that are given in your book. So the steps to change the row, first of all, we select or click anywhere in the row whose height or column width you want to change. So let's say we want to change the height of this particular row. In the cell size group, we can change the height. See, this is how we can change the height of the table. We can also change the width. So that's how we can change the row height and column width of the table. Next, applying borders and shading. So these are aesthetics only. We can change the borders of a table. First of all, you go to Table Tools. Click on the Design tab. In the Table Styles group, click the Border drop-down arrow. So we can select on any of the predefined border styles. We can, if we want to change the shading, we can click on shading and select a particular color from there, which will change the shading of that particular cell in the table. You can select multiple cells also, which will change the shading of all those cells together. Next, we can change the alignment of the text. So changing the alignment of text is same as changing text in a table cell is similar to changing the alignment of the text in normal table. For example, let's say we have written something. So we can make them center align, right align, justified align, left align. Many choices are there. So with that, we will be finishing today. So in the next part, we will be discussing the rest of the chapter. Thank you.